They real men out there. They super extra. But I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. The energy was crazy. Whole bunch of tough guys skating around on ice. It was dope. I'm a fan.
If PK Subban would hit you in the back of the head like he did McKinnon, what would you have done?
Owie. Ref.
Is that anything?
It's hard to say it when you're not on the ice, you know. It's hard to, you know, anybody can say, yeah, man, I did that. But those guys, they're true tough guys out there, skating in and off the ice, in and off the ice. Three periods, it's like two half times. You know, it's a tough sport. I got a newfound respect for those guys.
What about the moves that LA has made this offseason?
That's football for you, you know. It's not just here. It's all around the league. You know, this is how it is in the National Football League. That's just the game. It's just the sport we play.
On the additions, Keenum.
It's great. I mean, we signed Case, I reached out to him. Case is a great pickup for us. He's going to be able to do the things that we need at the quarterback position. He's a great guy. I knew him before he got here. I'm familiar with him. So I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go with Case.
Gone, do you take on an even bigger leadership role? Is that possible?
Yeah, I guess. I mean, I got to start slapping guys around in the locker room, and no, it's the same. I'm going to be the same for him regardless. You know, we already had leaders. You know, just because me and Lieb had to, you know, see on our chest don't mean we're the only captains. You know, Derek Wolf is a great leader. Derek Wolf, you know, he's the badge brother in there. And we got a lot of leaders in there. So it's tough not having, you know, Lieb with you, but, you know, we got guys that'll fill the void.
Vibe now,
just
being humbled by last year, does it feel like a fresh start? What is kind of the vibe as you resume and have
some of
the new guys around you for the first time?
Just be accountable. You want to let last season go, but you want to learn from it. You know, we want to be accountable. You know, it's a lot of things that we didn't do well, you know, last year. We want to get those things fixed. We want to play better. I need to play better, you know, just all across the board. You know, you're back to a winning culture, to get back to the type of team and the type of organization that we know we can be. We gotta win, and it starts with being accountable.
Bradley Chubb said a few times how much he models in the interview. Have you seen his tape? What do you think of him?
Yeah, he's Khalil Mack and Von Miller put together.
That's a pretty good player.
Yeah, he is a great player, and I would love to have him. You know, I love to have him on my team. You don't come across guys like that often, and you know, having a number five, you know, pick in the draft. You know, I hope we don't have, you know, a high pick like that for a while. So, you know, if we could, you know, steal a player like that, you know, I'm all for it.
With a higher pick than usual, do you yourself pay any more attention to this year's draft or lead up to the draft?
Oh, do I pay attention to the draft? Yeah, I mean, I'm on Twitter and Instagram just like everybody else, you know. I follow the NFL on Instagram. You know, I pay attention to the draft. You know, that's just part of the National Football League. It's kind of hard not to pay attention to the draft. You got the playoffs, you got the Super Bowl, you got free agency, then you got the draft, and they go back to OTAs, go to training camp. And it's such a big emphasis on all of those moments throughout the year. Football is really year-round now, so it's kind of hard not to pay attention to the draft.
What do you want the organization to do with that number five pick?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, I got all the faith in the guys that's running the organization. Whatever we do with it, whatever we can get. It's mock drafts. You talk about paying attention to the draft. Yeah, it's been all type of mock drafts where guys come here, guys come there. You know, whatever happens, I'm cool with it. We got Hall of Fame quarterback leading the organization. He's gonna make the best decision for our organization, and I'm with it.
Well, the quarterback though, knowing that you just signed Keenum, I mean, would you prefer it not be a quarterback because you just signed Keenum and it be a guy you thought might play right away, or do you think about that as players at all?
Oh, whoa. We're getting deep into the blog sites now. I don't know. We got a Hall of Fame quarterback, you know, leading the ship, so he's going to make a great decision for us, and, you know, just let him make those hard decisions. Whatever happens, I'm going to be cool with it. If we take, you know, Saquon, you know, I'm cool with that. If we take Chubb, I'm cool with that. If we trade it away, I'm cool with, you know, whatever he does with that pick.
What are you hoping to see from Shane Ray getting back to health this year?
I just want him to be Shane Ray. You know, if he could just be Shane Ray and the type of player that we all know he could be, that's more than enough. You know, he had one sack last year. You know, if he could do you know, anything better than that, that'd be great for us. This is a big year for Shane. Last year was a big year for Shane. I think you add those together, you know, he's going to have a phenomenal year. Getting hurt, that's just part of it. You know, all the great players get hurt. You know, all the great players are going to, you know, miss games, from Peyton Manning to Tom Brady to, you know, all these guys. Everybody has to battle through injury, and Shane, he's battled through that. He's back on the field now, and now it's time to play.
What's it like having Warren Landau in the building leading the offseason workouts?
Oh, it's great. You know, Luke Richardson was great for us. Lauren Landau is going to be great for us as well. I'm familiar with Lauren. I worked out with Lauren for, you know, the last, you know, like 3-4 years. So I'm familiar with Lando. It's kind of weird, you know, seeing him in the building. I'm like, oh, the gym right down the street. You know, and now he in the building. So it's good. It's great having a guy like that. He's gonna do exactly what we need him to be. He's gonna get everybody healthier, stronger. We're not gonna take a step back when it comes to strength and conditioning.
Would you like to be in Bill's room? To go work with Bill Carter.
What did you say, Nikki? You said something.
It is my heart.
You said you feel like you need to play better, which seems a little crazy because you had a heck of a season, but are there specific areas?
Yeah, I'm supposed to get 30 sacks. So if I'm not getting 30 sacks. I just wanna be great, man. I just wanna be great. I only play in the postseason. You know, when you get a taste of, you know, making big time sacks in the postseason, you wanna do that all the time. You know, and not been able to do that for the last 2 years. You know, I got to play better. I got to get the guys to play better around me, and that's what a good leader and a good player does. So I got to play better. Got to get everybody else playing better around me. And if we can do that, you know, we'd be right back where we need to be.
Bob, were you surprised by some of the negative comments about the fishing trip that you went on?
What were you saying? You said something like that. I was shocked. You know, I was shocked. I went fishing. You know, everybody knows that I hunt and fish. That's what I do. But I also believe in conservation. You know, I'm not just out there going crazy. You know, it happened. We followed the rules. I did everything I was supposed to do. But, you know, the guys chopping. The whole thing was on my Instagram story. So, you know, people chop and paste that and, you know, make what they want to make. But, you know, we're here now, and I followed the rules. I did everything I was supposed to do, and, you know, we just leave it where that was at, where it's at.
You talked to anybody from Peter or anybody like that?
No, I haven't talked to anybody. I haven't talked to anybody about it. You know, it's a serious deal. You know, I don't want to, you know, be lighthearted about it. That's just me. But, you know, we did everything we were supposed to do when it comes to that situation.
What's it gonna be like to get into a daily basis with Bill Polar?
You said what again, Mike? Yeah, I ask the tough questions up here. I mean, I'm a whatever coach that I have, I'm gonna make his job easy. You know, it really doesn't matter who I have coaching me. Being in a room with Bill, he's a character. You know, I'm a character, and you know, it's not gonna be a power struggle. It's his room. You know, I'm the player. He's the coach. You know, we can leave it at that. My job is to go out there and get sacks. His job is to help me with that. So, you know, whatever he thinks is, however he wants to lead it, I'm right there with him. I'm sitting in the passenger seat. You know, maybe I might be even sitting in the back seat. You know, whatever he wants me to do, you know, I'm gonna do it.
A few more for Vaughn.
You mentioned reaching out to Keenum right when he signed, but maybe how have you seen him kind of acclimate himself since he signed, or what do you hope to see from him now as you guys are working out together?
And it's only been, I don't know, what, 4 hours, you know? But he's a great leader. You can just tell by being around guys, you know, by having a conversation with guys, you know, in 30 seconds, you can kind of, you know, tell what, you know, he's going to bring. He's going to be a great quarterback for us. He's going to be a great leader. His locker is right across the mile, right where DeMarcus used to be. So I envision, like, a whole bunch of magical moments between, you know, me and Case and, you know, holding hands and dancing around in the locker room. So it'd be great. You know, I'm a great guy in the locker room. He'd be a great guy, and all we gotta do now is just get the wins coming in.
Bob, will you be doing the Stanford camp thing that you did last year? Are you gonna be doing that again, or anything with the Broncos linebackers?
Yeah. Pastor Summit. This will be year two. We're still finalizing, you know, where we're gonna do it at, and, you know, the sponsors and all that stuff. But we're definitely gonna have it again. It was a great event. I don't plan on letting that go, you know, anytime soon. Whenever you can get the rookies in there and, you know, vets and guys like, you know, DeMarcus and Bruce Smith and, you know, Warren Sapp, you know, all these guys, they want to come back and help. So, you know, whenever you can get all these guys in a room and we could just share knowledge, it's a magical thing.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you guys, appreciate it.